moon tower, their harmful effects on humans, animals, birds and environment. Episode 2. Neuronal damage of this kind may not have immediate consequences, but in the long run, it may result in reduced brain reserve capacity that might be unveiled by other later neuronal diseases. It must be noted that the blood-brain barrier and neurons are the same in a rat and a human being. In another research, a single 2-hour exposure to a cell phone, just once during its lifetime, permanently damaged the blood-brain barrier, and, on autopsy 50 days later, was found to have damaged or destroyed up to 2% of an animal's brain cells, including cells in areas of the brain concerned with learning, memory and movement. It is known that this barrier is damaged in Alzheimer's and Parkinson's disease. So there is a risk that disruption of this protection barrier may damage the brain. Risk to children and pregnant women. Children are more vulnerable to cell phone radiation as they absorb more energy than adults from the same phone owing to their smaller head and brain size, thinner cranial bones and skin, thinner, more elastic ears, lower blood cell volume, as well as greater conductivity of nerve cells, and the energy penetrates more deeply. Tumors in the midbrain are more deadly than in the temporal lobe. Children's cells reproduce more quickly than adults, which makes cancers more deadly. Their immune system is not as well developed as adults, hence are less effective against fighting cancer growth. Children have longer lifetime exposure. The younger the child, the deeper is the penetration, due to the fact that their skulls are thinner and still developing. For these reasons, it is critical that children under the age of 16 use cell phones only for short essential calls, as they have much bigger danger of getting a brain tumor. Brain tumors have now taken over leukemia as the biggest cause of death amongst children. Due to these reasons, countries like Belgium, France, Finland, Germany, Russia and Israel have publicly discouraged use of cell phones by children. An independent research in Sweden last year concluded there was an astonishing 420% increased chance of getting brain cancer for cell phone users who were teenagers or younger when they first started using their phones. A pregnant woman and the fetus both are vulnerable because of the fact that these RF radiations continuously react with the developing embryo and increasing cells. Microwave radiation can damage the placental barrier, the membrane which prevents the passage of some materials between the maternal and fetal blood, protecting the fetus, implying that pregnant woman should avoid cell phone or use during emergency. In a recent finding, an association was found between a mother's cell phone use during pregnancy and greater likelihood for spontaneous abortion, congenital malformations and behavioral problems in their children. It is believed that the eggs which form the embryo are affected, and the damage will become apparent after the child reaches puberty. The Russian National Committee on Non-Ionizing Radiation Protection says that use of the phones by both pregnant women and children should be limited. It concludes that children who talk on the handsets are likely to suffer from disruption of memory, decline of attention, diminishing learning and cognitive abilities, increased irritability in the short term, and that long-term hazards include depressive syndrome and degeneration of the nervous structures of the brain. Irreversible infertility. Recent studies confirm that cell phone radiation can drastically affect male fertility. In 2006, the American Society for Reproductive Medicine reported that use of cell phones by men is associated with decrease in semen quality, sperm count, motility, variability and normal morphology, and is related to the duration of cell phone use. Studies have found 30% sperm decrease in intensive mobile phone users, in addition to damage of sperms. The average sperm count was found to be at 59 million sperm per milliliter of seminal fluid, compared to 83 million for men not continually exposed to mobile phone radiation. Similarly, the study found that motility, the power of the sperm to swim, was affected by mobile phone transmissions. Men who made lengthy calls had fewer rapidly motile sperm, 36.3% compared with 51.3% for men who made no calls. It was found that not only does using a phone affect a man's sperm quality, but simply having it switched on in a pocket was enough to do damage, as mobile phones periodically but briefly transmit information to cell towers to establish contact. Radiation from cell phone can also produce DNA breaks in sperm cells that can mutate and cause cancer. Damage to sperm DNA increases the risk further and can pass on the genetic changes to subsequent generations. Due to these reasons, it is advisable to never wear or use any wireless device near reproductive organs. Men planning to father children are advised to make sure that they stop using wireless devices well in advance of fertilization to reduce the chance of procreation with damaged sperm. Calcium ion release from cell membranes. Studies have shown that weak electromagnetic fields remove calcium ions bound to the membranes of living cells, making them more likely to tear, develop temporary pores and leak. Leakage of calcium ions into the cytosol, the fluid found inside cells, acts as a metabolic stimulant, which accelerates growth and healing, but it also promotes the growth of tumors. Leakage of calcium ions into brain cells generates spurious action potentials, nerve impulses, accounting for pain and other neurological symptoms in electrosensitive individuals. It also degrades the signal-to-noise ratio of the brain, making it less likely to respond adequately to weak stimuli. DNA damage. Cellular telephone frequencies can lead to damaged DNA. Studies show that microwave exposure at levels below the current Federal Communications Commission exposure standard produces single and double-strand breaks in DNA. Electromagnetic radiation causes membrane leakage due to loss of calcium ions. Leaks in the membranes of lysosomes, small bodies in living
Click
cells
add button to install
digestive
extension.
Enzymes
Click
release
add
DNA
button to install extension.
An enzyme that destroys DNA, which explains the fragmentation of DNA seen in cells exposed to mobile phone signals. interference with other gadgets including pacemakers. Cell phone radiation interferes with navigational equipment, therefore its use is banned in airborne flights. Electromagnetic interference from mobile phones can cause malfunctioning of lifeline electronic gadgets in the hospitals, thereby potentially endangering patients. It is also advisable to restrict mobile phone use in clinical areas like operating theatres and intensive care units. RF exposure from mobile phones and cellular phone base antennas can also affect patients carrying pacemaker, implantable cardiovascular defibrillators, ICDs, and impulse generators. The signals generated by mobile phones cause electromagnetic interference with the device and interfere with its proper functioning. The signals produced by cell phone operating functions, like turning on, ringing, conversation and turning off, contain components of low frequencies that can interfere with the implanted pacemakers, causing them to become arrhythmic, which in adverse conditions can put the patient to death. Effects on stress proteins, heat shock proteins. Non-thermal effects of radio frequency radiation accumulate over time and the risks are more pronounced after several years of exposure. The effects are not observed in the initial years of exposure, as the body has certain defense mechanisms and the pressure is on the stress proteins of the body, namely the heat shock proteins. The highly conserved HSPS accumulate in cells exposed to heat and a variety of other stressful stimuli like heavy metal poisoning and oxygen deprivation. HSPS, which function mainly as molecular chaperones, allow cells to adapt to gradual changes in their environment and to survive in otherwise lethal conditions. Effect on skin. Radiation from cell towers and mobile phones affects human skin. People who talk often on cell phones have a higher concentration of the transretin protein than those who do not. Transretin is formed in the liver. It helps transport vitamin in the body and plays an important role in nervous diseases such as Alzheimer's. The symptoms of Morgellons disease include those of electromagnetic hypersensitivity, EHS, may be based on how body uses electric currents to repair wounds to the skin. People who suffer from this condition report a range of skin symptoms including crawling, biting and stinging sensations, granules, threads or black speck-like materials on or beneath the skin and or lesions, for example common rashes or sores. Electromagnetic force degrade the immune system and stimulate various allergic and inflammatory responses. The high radiation from cell towers can result in an increase in mast cells, which explains the clinical symptoms of itch, pain, edema and erythema. There will be a total of 4 episodes on this subject which will be live streamed at 24-hour interval. Broadcast of the next episode will be at 21 hours IST on the next day. All are requested to spread this message by sharing as much as possible. Comments are also solicited.